Degrees or radians? Let's learn physics. Our students understand degrees. They can think in degrees. They can even measure degrees. That 360 degrees in a circle? That's because there are exactly 30 days in a month, and 12 months in a year, and 12 times 30 for 360 days in a year. Exactly. Some old calendars even had a leap month every 5 or 6 years to catch up. Degrees are dumb. But we understand degrees because we have protractors and we can measure in degrees. And compasses in degrees. And navigation for boats and ships heading in degrees. But radians? I barely understand radians and my students have no clue. The angle swept out by a radial line is defined as the ratio of the arc length to the radius for a circle. And since the units divide out, the radian is what we call a dimensionless unit, a simple ratio. Since the circumference, the arc length in a whole circle, is equal to 2 pi times the radius, there are 2 pi radians of angle measure in a whole circle of turn. Sounds complicated. That impression of complicatitude is one of our impediments to a good understanding of radians. Pi, of course, is just like x or y in algebra. Except it's not at all. Pi is a number. It's a number that shows up in our natural world again and again and again. It's the ratio of the circumference of every circle to its diameter. Every circle. It's the ratio of the surface area of every circle to the square of its radius. Pi is 3/4 the volume of a sphere divided by the cube of its radius. Pi shows up in physics equations again and again and again. It's real and irrational, just like all of you. And one full circle is 2 pi radians, 6.28 blah 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 radians. And half a circle is 3.14, etc. radians.
1 radian, 2 radians, 3 radians, 4 radians, 5 radians, 6 radians.
1 radian is a bit less than 1/6 of one full turn around a circle. So why don't our students understand those radians? Or pi? Because I've never even seen a protractor in radians.
If you look at a math catalog, you can find them. They exist, but they're really uncommon.
I've never seen a compass in radians.
So I came out here looking for some radians. No luck. But I did find some degrees. It's a bit cold out here.
And I've never even considered using radians for anything but math class. And only certain parts of math class. It's unused in almost everything I know. It's just like the metric system we use in physics class and in chemistry class. And why would I ever need to speak a different language? I do. I can switch back and forth from feet and inches to meters and centimeters when working with my brother-in-law, my Syrian brother-in-law, on a home project. Yo puedo contar una historia en kilómetros y kilómetros por hora a mi familia en Paraguay. But that's only because I won't be understood if I don't. Radians are real, and they're better than degrees in almost every way. Degrees are physically smaller divisions, so maybe that's why they use degrees on protractors. But, like many things, we use degrees, and we use kilometers, and we use gallons, and we use 24 hours a day, and 60 minutes in an hour, and 60 seconds in a minute, not because they make more sense, they often don't, but because we're used to them, and that's what we've always done. And we won't change until we have to.